A lot of people who say, smart brain is born. I'm not gifted. No, people who say, you will say, mama, don't compare me with my friend because I'm not gifted. I'm not that great. Is it? That's why he get better result or he got promotion, but not me. Right? A lot of us will actually say this way. We actually say, we are not gifted. That's why we cannot do that much, you know, that's why we cannot perform. And sometimes it's about your mental. You actually give up yourself. You do nothing. When you say that, why you say no? You see, no matter how I work on it, I will never be there. That's why sometimes you say, better I do nothing. No matter how much effort I put in, I will not able to deliver the end result, so I can start. I do nothing. It's actually you give up yourself, you see, and another person, they keep trying, and at the end, they achieve. So a lot of people say, nothing I can do, I'm not gifted, right? Actually, this is not right. I can prove to you this is not right. And in fact, all of us are gifted. We have a great brain. Trust me. Just that, you do not have the manual, which means what? You see, when you buy a TV, right, you do not have to switch on, what will you do? Get the manual, right? You know, to see, operating place, like this button for to switch on. Okay? Even when you buy your handphone, okay, your new handphone, you don't know how to use this manual. But since you're born, right, is there any manual given to your parent and say, this way, that's how you use your brain? Is there any manual? None, right? Nothing, right? That's why you see, we invented a lot of things, but we don't even know how to use our brain. That's the main problem, you see. So later we are going to teach you how to use your brain. Okay, learning is an ongoing process. That's why I think you are here. I think it's very, very good. You spend your time, you spend your 2 hours. Some of you are students, still learning, and some are working it out. You spend your time, take a day off, just learn, right? Brain can be trained, trust me. And everyone has great potential. Okay, so how much to learn about your brain? Where is your brain? First question. Where's your brain? Can you show me? Can you point to me? Here lah. Okay lah. Luckily you point it lah. You know, I need to confirm, I need to check. Why? Because during my last seminar, right, someone said it's here. I said, why? My parents say so. Since I was young, they said, that's why you thought. Okay, so is I need to confirm, you know where your brain is, right? This time your problem with your brain. Do you face any problem with your brain? Do you face any problem? Any of you can share any problem that you face with your brain? Anything about with your brain? Nothing. Forgetful. Lucky that someone say something. Otherwise, I'm thinking to say, if nothing, then thank you very much. We can go to the section now. Since you have no problem with your brain, right? So I got nothing much to say, right? Now, please someone say something, easy to forget. Alright? What else? No, easy to forget. Sometimes, your superior, or your lecturer asks you to do this, ask you to do a homework, or instruction given, you cannot remember. The next day when you go to work, and you realize, oops, I forgot to do something. Okay, I forgot to do my homework, right? What else? I think forget is a main issue. For students that still need to take exam, some people they study very, very hard, from morning until evening, never sleep. But when they step into the exam, oh god. Right? It's a mental jam, right? Mental block, it happened, right? Right. What else? When you go for shopping mall, you couldn't remember where you park your car. Have you ever experienced that? You did, right? Yeah, okay. And sometimes, you feel like, did I lock my door or something, right? What else? What other problem with your brain? Sometimes you want to study, you cannot concentrate. Yeah, it's a problem as well. Yeah, cannot concentrate, or easy to daydream, or probably some of you already start to daydream, you see what I'm cooking, start to daydream. That's another problem, right? Yeah, this is another problem. But I'm not going to spend more time on this. Otherwise, you probably end up spend another 1 hour just to talk about problem. I think we want to talk about solutions, right? We want to solve it, right? Yeah, we want to improve it, right? That is the reason you are here, right? Not to talk about problems, right? So I'm not going to spend too much time on this. So we need to understand basic of our brain functions, okay? In order to operate better, okay? You want to drive a car, you need to understand your car. You know, if you're very conscious, then you say you want to go for 150 km per hour, of course you cannot, right? You know, you need to understand your brain in order to operate, right? Okay, I'll try to record one by one. So I'll close my eyes so that you will not say, you know, I'll reach someone there, you know, and tell me the answer, or try to show me the answer, I'll close my eyes. Right, let's start. 3, 4, 8, 4, 8, 7, 2, 3, 9, 4, 2, 7, 3, 1, 7, 8, 2, 6, 5, 9, 8, 1, 0, 2, 6, 3, 7, 3, 3, 9, 6, 7, 8. What's mind map? A mind map is an easy way to get information into and out of your brain. Okay? You can get in the information easily to your brain and take out from your brain. Okay? You know, that's very important. You know, a lot of us, we study a lot, we read a lot, we learn a lot, we attended a lot of workshops, you know, a lot of classes. We try to put in a lot of information to our brain. But when we need it, I think I learned it before. I just cannot recall. Alright? You don't know how to take it out from your brain. Okay? So we'll teach you how to take out from your brain. A new way of studying and revising that's quick and work. A way of taking notes that is not boring. When we talk about taking notes, right, a lot of us will say, I don't want to take notes, it's so boring. Alright? Okay? So this one way of taking notes that's not boring. Best way of coming out with new ideas and planning your projects. Alright? When you feel like, you know, you want to come out with a project, you want to do a proposal, then you need ideas, right? But you don't know where to get your ideas, right? And mind map will help you. Make out a word, colors, lines, and picture. What mind map can help you? Can help you to remember better, okay? Make better notes. Help you to concentrate, help you to focus. Stay focused is very important. We are very easy to get distracted. Come up with new idea, creative idea, and save your time and make the most of your time. I think nowadays, you know, all of us are busy, right? So we don't have time. So we will need to really work very efficiently, okay, in order to not utilize your time, to maximize the return of your time, to get better results for those who are still studying. Organize your thinking, your planning, okay, and even your presentation and your life. And mind map can help you in any mental activity, any activity that related to your brain, okay, related to your mental, okay, it will help you. There are three types of mind maps. Generally, there are three types of mind maps. First, be full images, right? It's good for, you know, for a good intro, but you need explanation. A lot of people will say, mind map is not easy to learn. Why? Because you need to draw, and I'm not good at drawing. That's why I don't like mind map, or I can't mind map. No, I heard, yeah, I know, it's not, a lot of people say mind map is good, but it's not for me. Why? Because I'm not good at drawing. That's not my actually, that's not my. You don't need to be good at drawing to come out of mind map. Okay, this text. No, you don't need to draw. You can write. Right? But of course, you can use the mixture of it, okay? Both words and some images, okay? The combination of it, right? Generally, there are three types of mind maps. So sometimes when you do a very nice mind map, right, with this type, then you say, no, I cannot draw, you cannot have a mind map. In fact, it's not done. You can use other type of mind map as well. This is a full image, full text, and the combination of it, right? How to start a mind map? Actually, it's very simple, very easy. You do not need to bring a suitcase, you know, to start a mind map. You just need a very, very simple tool. Paper. Just a blank paper. Okay, blank paper will do, right? A4 blank paper. You should use A4 paper or A3 paper. Okay, A4 and A3. Better use a high quality one. Because if you want to keep it right, then if you get at least 100 grams, I would say 100 grams will be better for you to keep the mind map. And when you want to add in more information, so it's easier for you to refer, to review, and also to add in, right, to revise as well. And we need color bands. Okay, we need color bands. Generally, we need at least four colors, right, to make the mind map look more interesting, right? And then catch your attention and catch your eyes, right? And the last one, you need to bring your brain. Is that very complicated to start mind map? No, you just need three things. I think this one you always carry, right? Your brain, you always carry with you, right? So that it can just use paper and color pens, right? Okay, how to mind map? Before you mind map, right? Let me show you some of the rules of the mind map, okay? You need to understand the rules. First, paper, okay? We use blank paper. We don't use the line paper, we use a blank paper. Okay? As I said, line paper will be tend to your left brain activity, right? So we use blank paper. And we always place it sideways, landscape, so that you can put in more information, okay? We are going to draw a mind map together in a short while, yeah? But before we start, right, we need to understand, we need to know the rules and regulations. Right? We always start from center, from middle, okay? We always start from center. Center will be the topic or the title of the mind map. And that's your first impression, the middle. You always put the middle first, right? Okay? So that's your first impression. That's why it's very, very important. Usually we will use picture. Okay? Usually we draw it, okay? Simple drawing, right? Then you can use more colors, okay, for your middle image, at least three colors. Can you see from the back? Can you see? Okay, right. The third one, the third rules, the lines. Okay, the lines. It should be from the thicker line to a thinner line. As you can see from here, right, from the thicker line to a thinner line. Right, thicker to thinner. And the line, right, is not a straight line. Our brain, right, do not think in a straight way. Right, it's a organic. Okay, organic. Okay, the lines should be as organic as we can. Okay, organic. Organic. And the line, okay, it should be each word on each line, okay, each word on each line, not too long and not too short. It should be just line to fit the word that we want to put on it, right? And the line should be connected, okay, it should be connected to each other, it should be connected. So that if you do not connect the line, right, your brain will actually perceive it is complete or is finished, so that it will not help you to get more ideas, right? That's why all these lines, right, are connected, right? And we need to put on some colors. More color would be good, okay? So you can capture your attention, okay? Do you like to watch those black and white kind of TV program? You like the color one? You like the color one, the colorful one, right? Okay? That's why color always good to capture your attention, help you to remember, right? People like to see colorful things as well, right? When you show your presentation, you know, in one, all black. Don't open people say they are so boring, I don't want to read your notes, okay? I don't want to do revision because it's so boring, right? But it's colorful. Hey, what will you say? Now I'm okay to read. Okay, that's why color. Okay, remember you want to put color, but don't simply put color. It's loose to follow as well. You can see each color one is for which each branch. One color for one branch. Okay, you can see here blue color for this branch and green color for the other branch. Okay, each color for each branch. And words, right? We put the words as well. You don't have to draw all the time. Okay, we put the keyword. Okay. We always choose keyword. One keyword. Okay, we always choose keyword, right? And according to the research, right? Most of the time of the article, right? You do not need to memorize the whole thing, remember the whole things. In fact, you just need to pick up 10% of it, 10% of the keyword will help you to recall or remember the whole articles, the whole things. You don't need to go word by word, you don't need to remember word by word. You just gotta remember the keywords, okay? 10% of the keyword will help you to remember the whole things. Okay, and the words that you put, right, it should be on top of the line. Okay, on top of the line, see the words on top of the line, not next to the line. I think a lot of us, you know, when we do the mind map, you know, when we do the notes, we put next to the line. That's why, as I said, line should be connected. Okay, so the words should be on top of it. And we usually choose nouns or verb to put in on our mind map. Because that one will be easier to help you to trigger, okay, to trigger the whole articles, the whole sectors, the whole point. Okay, help you to trigger the whole point. And the last one, we put some pictures or images. First, the center, if you can, try to put the images, right? And those important points, right? You can use picture to beautify it, put some picture on it, right? So it will help you to capture your attention. Alright, then of course when you put pictures, right, when you do the revision, it will be fun. Alright, then easier for you to remember as well. It's how we do the mind map. Okay, the last one, I put some images, right? That is how mind map look like, and these are the general rules in order for you to start mind map.